Come on in, everybody, to Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky, the home of the Kentucky Wildcats, but this weekend, the home of the Southeast Regional. Game one, North Carolina and Ohio State, the Buckeyes, the one seed in the Southeast. Michigan and Oklahoma State later tonight. Four schools at all can lay claim to having won at least one national championship. They're all gathered here in Lexington. Hi, everybody. Jim Nance along with Billy Packer, your duo here in Lexington. And Billy, what do we expect in the first game, North Carolina, Ohio State?
Jim, something's got to give here tonight. Both of these clubs in the NCAA tournament have held their opponents below 35% shooting. And their two stars, Hubert Davis for North Carolina and Jim Jackson for Ohio State, are shooting at 25%. Whatever guy gets off first, that's the team's going to be in control.
Well, the starting lineups, Carolina with three sophomores starting, Hubert Davis, the lone senior, and Ohio State has three seniors, plus junior Jim Jackson. The officials, Don Rutledge from Windermere, Florida, Bobby Deibler, El Paso, Texas, and Scott Thornley, Pocatello, Idaho. Captain Jamal Brown. The road to the regional semifinals through Mississippi Valley State and UConn. For Carolina, a scare against Miami of Ohio, and then they shut down Alabama 29% from the floor to advance here to Lexington.
Good quick leap by Funderburke. Jackson wasn't sure which direction he was going.
Bounced off the foot of Derek Phelps and Ohio State. In the gray uniforms with the gray sneakers. And Mark Baker is their point guard. Jim Jackson handles a lot of the ball handling chores as well. Here's Baker.
And Brian Reese guarding him. It's going to be quite an assignment for Reese.
Chris Gent.
Jackson trying to post Reese up here early in the game.
Funderburke out high. Jamal Brown. He can shoot a three. Yes. Traveling violation against Jim Jackson, who has struggled, as Billy mentioned, in this tournament, 10 out of 39 from the floor in the first two games.
And Jim 0 for 9 in his first nine attempts against Connecticut. Straight man-to-man by both teams, and they really match up well size-wise.
Now the number four seed, the Tar Heels with the ball for the first time. Reese gets it in the corner to Phelps. Montross, who has been outstanding, kicks it back out to Phelps.
Davis is a great matchup as well, talking about tough offense and tough defense.
Good lob pass, and Montross gets the game's first points.
Montross has been the difference so far for North Carolina in regard to his offense in the NCAA tournament.
Gent bounces it in to Jackson, and Reese wrapped around the body to commit his first. And here's the pass from Lynch. So Montross.
When you have a 6-7 man entering the ball as opposed to a guard, it makes that lob so much more effective. Funderburke has a quickness advantage on Montross, but he can't handle him down in that low post.
Jackson gives it up to Funderburke.
Jimmy said it time and time again in doing Ohio State games this year. Lawrence Funderburke gets off the floor for a big man as quickly as anybody in the college game. He's probably given up probably 40 pounds, though, to Montross in the low post.
Oh, he's stolen away. Jackson was right there.
Smart play by Jackson, too, to see if he was going to be chased down the floor.
Almost another steal as they went to Reese in the lane. That's to tie it at four.
Reese, an excellent penetrator. And Jim Jackson's going to take a spot down in the low post. Gent going to play on the outside. He can do that.
Baker off the setup to Funderburke. His second dunk already.
Jim, North Carolina, as has always been their custom, loves to force people to drive baseline. But we've seen on two occasions today, with great interior passing and no chance for the weak side defender to come over and help out, two dunks by Funderburke.
saw a glance of Dean Smith going for his 50th NCAA tournament victory tonight. He has the all-time highest total of wins in the tournament, 49, topping John Wooden's 47 wins.
Rodel in the game is in there for defense on Jackson. Maybe a better matchup inside.
Lynch to the line for two. Jamal Brown on the hack.
Now we watch how North Carolina, watch. See, they force people to go baseline. They're looking for help inside, but when Montross comes over, there's nobody from the weak side to help because Reese was tied up so much with Jim Jackson.
64% from the line. Carolina's top rebounder.
And of course, his steal in the Miami of Ohio game really sealed things up for North Carolina.
Henrik Rodel in for the Heels. Ryan Reese sits. Tied at six.
Jim, you notice Hubert Davis has not touched the ball. Jamal Brown is really doing a job on him on the other end of the floor so far tonight. Of course, he's done a great job on a number of guys. Regular season in NCAA tournament. Remember the Kenny Anderson game a few years ago.
Pass. No look pass, and Funderburke misses the hook. Keeps it alive for the Buckeyes. Baker will have the open shot.
Good block out Lynch that time.
Rodel on the try. Stolen away by Funderburke.
And North Carolina is going to have to figure out shortly how to get Davis, Hubert Davis, the ball to get some shots off. He hasn't touched it.
Again, Funderburke misses the short one, but now a six.
He is so quick off the floor. That second rebound of his is amazing.
He did not join the starting lineup till late in the season. They haven't lost with him in the starting lineup. And there's Hubert Davis. Only an 8 out of 32 coming into the game in the tournament.
Good screen down through the lane to free him.
Jet three-pointer. Montross out of it now to Phelps. Carolina brings it up the floor quickly.
Davis is trying to bury Brown down on the baseline and then pop out from that double screen. Here he comes. Good switch by Jen.
Again, inside Montross. Hammered on the arm. Jackson's first. Now, some of you will be shortly switching to Georgia Tech and Memphis State. The Midwest Regional from Kansas City, scheduled for an 8-18 tip. We'll be getting you there for the start of that game. Montross at the line for Carolina, 61% free throw shooter. Funderburke getting a blow as Bill Robinson comes in. I'd mentioned that Funderburke started late in the season in the starting five. Robinson had been going with the first group up until that time.
Well, the bodies that Funderburke will be against tonight is going to hurt him.
Under 16, official timeout, Heels by two. Jim Nance and Billy Packer from Lexington. Carolina hot so far.
Well, Jim, I said at the start of the show, something's got to give so far in North Carolina. We talked about that 35%. Both teams were holding others down, but North Carolina hadn't missed a shot either from the field or the foul line yet, and they come out in their .131 zone here.
Jamal Brown, three.
42% three-point shooter. Big lift for Randy Ayer's team if they can hit from the perimeter. Excellent skip court.
Reese on the blocks. Lynch coming through and back under the cylinder for two.
Great skip pass by North Carolina to set up the inside feed.
That skip pass from Montross. 12-11 Tar Heels.
Again, Jim, we talk about feeding the post. If you can feed it with a big man, it's so much better to get angles.
Jamal Brown, one more time. Oh, rattled out.
Montross very slow getting to the ball. Brown almost picked it off.
From the floor, Reese keeps it alive to Phelps.
Good officiating there. Reese had not yet hit the floor before he released the ball. Boy, Robinson and Montross, what a shoving match inside.
His career-high numbers in the opening round win against Miami. 22 points, 13 rebounds. He has six here at the start.
Second time tonight they've been able to drive the left side down on the baseline and no weak side help. Jim, in that game you're talking about, Montross was 11 for 13 from the floor. So really utilized when he got the ball, utilized it well.
Tar Heels.
Lynch averages 14 a game. Gets those mostly inside the foul line area.
Jackson, two defenders on him. They take it away. From behind, the foul against Robinson.
I don't know. Is it Robinson or Jackson, Jim? It could be Jackson second.
Foul is on Jackson.
It is on Jackson. Jim Jackson with his second.
For North Carolina, Rodel.
Funderburke returns.
Salvatore.
I don't know. If Randy realizes that it's Jackson's second, here'd be an opportunity to try to free Reese up a little bit and have him take Jackson.
Kevin Salvatore, Philly, is in for North Carolina.
He'll be able to hold his own inside against Robinson. Good shot blocker.
Pat Sullivan also in off the bench. This is Sullivan, sophomore from New Jersey. Funderburke bounced it right off Sullivan, right in front of us.
Well, you see what happens when Reese did not come back to handle the ball. Phelps is out of the game right now. Now, Phelps is the first time he sat down. He played 40 minutes in the last ball game. And he's sitting down now, so there was nobody in the backcourt to really take over. North Carolina back in the 2-3.
One seven-footer with another one. Three-point try. Rodel has it. Snaps it out to Davis.
Pull-up jump shot.
Challenges Baker. No basket. Foul outside against Baker. Midwest. UTEP and Cincinnati later tonight. Memphis State and Georgia Tech about to go.
Jim, a great story in that Georgia Tech. Bobby Crimmins lined up his team in that sideline out of bounds that they won the ball game with the other day. When they passed the ball to James Forrest, he turned, took the jump shot, and didn't hit into anything. Didn't hit the rim, didn't hit the basket, so it shows you the fine line between advancing or going home in this tournament. Somebody's open. Sullivan.
Davis. Foot on the line. It's a two. Pure-looking jumper that time.
He's got his touchback. In the previous eight games before the tournament, Davis had been averaging 27 a game. Lost that touch, maybe due to the ankle injury. Wasn't getting the elevation on his jump shot. Now they're back to that 1-3-1 point zone. Salvatore.
Salvatore, who led this team in blocked shots, gets one to start the break. Rodel. Salvatore on the follow. They say basket interference.
Well, he had to be a little bit more patient, Jim. He had the inside position. Even if Rodel had missed, he could have gathered himself and put it back in.
Official timeout. North Carolina leading by five.
Forget about one-size-fits-all as a marketing strategy. Today, you have to make each customer feel unique.
Well, with Carolina on an 8-2 run, let's bring in the third member of our CBS announced crew, Sports Illustrated's Curry Kirkpatrick.
Jim, every time Dean Smith steps on the court in this tournament, another record bites the dust, usually one of his own. But tonight, he's playing in a building named for a man he's chasing for the all-time record in victories, Adolph Rupp. He needs 135. That's about 5 years' worth, and nobody thinks Dean won't get it. But he's already matched the master in one category, and that's most buildings named after oneself. Back to you guys.
Well, he had an all-time record of 5-2 against Rupp to Dean Smith.
Oh, what a tap that time by Jim Jackson.
There he is again, Jett on the follow. Four tries and Carolina comes out with it.
Hard to believe they couldn't put that one away.
4-on-2 and Reese had it knocked away with a piece of the arm.
Jim, when you talk about that record 5-2 against the Baron, we do have to remember that Coach Rupp's greater years were not when Dean Smith first came along. There you see that record, and you can see another man who had a great legend, Henry Iba, whose great legend we will be seeing tonight. One of his disciples, Eddie Sutton, playing in the second game.
Montross back, but you saw the list. Dean Smith next year, with a good year, could move up to number two. Moving past Fog Allen next.
You know, what's amazing when you talk about Dean Smith, a good year. What is a good year for Dean Smith? I mean, what he has been able to do is mind-boggling.
Well, what isn't a good year for Dean Smith?
That's right. Sweet 16 for the 12th time.
Two for Reese. The lead is extended to 9. Jamie Skelton has come in along with Alex Davis for Ohio State. And Rodel returns to the Tar Heel lineup.
Jim, a good year back to Dean Smith a little bit. He's had 22 straight years. He's won 20 games or more. So, you know, that's anything less than that, it's hard to comprehend for him. Back to man goes North Carolina. They've been able to switch their defenses after every timeout, just enough to throw Ohio State off, have to reset.
It's off a Carolina player so they can retain possession from the backcourt.
But they have to. The shot clock keeps moving. You don't get another 45 out of that. That was off Montross's leg. A clear out for Jim Jackson. A good double team by Davis.
Skelton running one-handed. That broke an 0-for-8 streak from the floor for the Buckeyes.
Now remember what Skelton did to turn things around at Indiana this year. Came in on that great 26-2 run Ohio State had.
Davis, he likes this shot. Rodel keeps it alive. Over the back on Montross, his first. Second on North Carolina.
Rodel's doing a fine job off the bench. He does not have great stats, but he came in and settled that matchup problem they had with Jim Jackson. Now they're going back to the zone.
Concentration error on Alex Davis.
And
who they turned it over.
Who other than Jent down on the floor diving out of bounds? You can remember Davis 2 years ago against Providence as a freshman. Had his biggest game of his career in NCAA tournament with 24. I think what Coach Ayers is trying to do right now is to give him a quick look, see if he's got it in him.
I remember that late night game on CBS.
Sir.
He sent the game into overtime. Rodel goes out. There is Davis. Kicks it back to Jackson.
Jent is really worn down. Smoke coming back up court.
Funderburke in a jam for a minute, but gets it back outside. Here is Jent.
The first thing that you shouldn't do when you're tired is take a long jump shot.
Control foul on Rodel.
And Jim, what's another thing you shouldn't do in the game? You've got a 3-on-2 break, pull up at the foul line, make the easy pass. Everybody in college basketball is going to wait on you to draw the charge. See, if he stops at the foul line, he has the same pass, better angle, and doesn't pick up the charge. Great man. Look at Rodel out there on Jackson.
Jackson is 1-for-5 from the floor.
A good hedge and double team, and that leaves Funderburke wide open.
Davis. Long rebound right back to him. Jackson's only make was an opening dunk.
On a steal. There again, the switch and a jump by North Carolina.
Phelps agrees. His first number 4 on North Carolina. And a tournament summary. The Big Ten and the ACC with 3 teams alive.
Entering the lineup, number 31, Brian Reese.
Record for Bobby Hurley last last night. And we've already got one against two set for the East and West Finals tomorrow. Reese is back for Dean Smith's ball club.
And they stay now in that, looks like a 2-3, and then it goes to that point zone, 1-3-1 look.
Skelton, three-pointer.
Trying to do is to give his starting guard combo a little rest here to come back out, wear down North Carolina.
Davis reached in and got the steal over to Skelton, who will challenge Roeder. Back out to Reese.
He can penetrate.
I don't know about that.
I don't agree with that call at all. Dean Smith upset and probably should be. Funderburke came right in underneath.
And he was already leaning back.
We'll see the drive. Reese is an excellent penetrator. There you can see Funderburke was starting down before the contact was made.
Second on Reese, an official timeout.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Rupp Arena is the only building to host both a men's and women's Final Four. North Carolina leading in Southeast Regional Semifinal action by 7. Jim Nance and Billy Packer. Ohio State the 1 seed against Carolina, the 4 seed in this regional.
There you can see that 1-3-1 matchup again. Tough shot.
Funderburke tipped in by Jackson.
Hubert Davis not able to get down on the weak side. Jackson too strong for him on the rebound. Phelps was looking for the backdoor cut.
Carolina is back to its starting five.
You can see, Jim, when Funderburke can get 8 to 10 feet away from the basket, he has the advantage on Montross. When it turns out to be inside that area, it's all Montross with those 35 to 40 pound weight advantage that he has on it. Dean Smith giving Rodel a rest now on defense.
Blocked. A blocked Jint shot.
Davis ought to pull up here.
He heard it.
When you realize the referees are going to call the charge, pull up and take the jump shot. Don't try to work against what they've been doing all night.
You remember Ohio State trailed UConn 28-16 in the first half of that second round game. It's now 26-17. Buckeyes down 9.
Remember the substitution that turned that around? Ricky Dudley. He's the man on the side now. Randy Ayers trying to get some action inside. A little more power.
Two-pointer for Reese. Phelps just hanging on the baseline and bad pass.
Yeah, he just lost it on the dribble. Jimmy Jackson took it from him.
6'1", Mark Baker dunks it home.
Montross again looking for that lob. Dish.
Left-handed, tipped in again by Montross.
Inside 5 feet. Beautiful pass in.
Foul against Reese. That's his third. And look at Davis improvising with the left hand.
But the real good play here was Montross being patient enough to let the ball come outside the cylinder. Remember the play Salvadori and Rodel a few minutes ago, Jim? Salvadori just too anxious with the ball up there in the cylinder.
So Reese goes out with his third. Pat Sullivan is in for Reese. And Jackson gets a rest. And there's the substitution, Billy. Ricky Dudley for Ohio State has entered the game, a freshman from Henderson, Texas.
And Jent goes out, so they actually become smaller.
First free throw of the night for Ohio State. Funderburke nails it.
And here's an opportunity for North Carolina playing with a very big team on the floor. Ohio State playing probably with the smallest team they can put on the floor of their major players.
Thank you.
floor. Williams, this is a whole different league he's playing in right now to be the primary ball handler.
Under five to go, first half. Carolina by seven. Here's the freshman, Donald Williams.
There's the back door cut. They've been waiting on. Reverse dribble backdoor cut to Davis.
Funderburke has quick hands.
Oh, he does.
Skelton.
North Carolina ought to just try to get the ball in a half court set now, Jim, because they're so much bigger than Ohio State in this end of the floor. A little bit too impatient.
Traveling call on Sullivan.
You can see who Dean Smith is putting in a hurry, coming back with Phelps.
At the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, we will select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. In conjunction with the award, Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of both schools.
Boy, a lot of cat and mouse here by both outstanding coaches trying to use their entire bench.
Three dunks and a half.
How Phelps bringing the ball up the court just likes a clear out. Skelton doing a good job hawking him.
Jamal Brown got him with the body, they say.
Now, excellent pump fakes that time by Davis. Brown, such a superior defensive player. Did a job on Woody Austin of Purdue this year in a great defensive effort, but got caught up in the air that time.
And that is his third. Skelton goes to the bench. Brown will join him. Jint comes in, along with Mark Baker.
Jim, one of the things I think we're seeing out here tonight are two quality basketball programs, well-coached, in excellent condition, but all of the players are realizing, maybe even for the first time in this tournament, what it's like to step up to the next level of competition. And they're all wearing down. You can see they're having to go to the bench tonight.
Salvadori, seven-footer in for seven-foot Montross. Hubert Davis, about 83% from the line. He's been nursing a sprained ankle, but looked fine yesterday in practice and superb so far tonight.
Well, the thing about Davis also, he's a 90% free throw shooter throughout his career in NCAA tournament play.
He one time made 29 straight in the tournament.
Timeout on the floor. The 13th
last official timeout of the first half
of the Midwest region, Memphis State.
Yo, Sinbad here with the black top shoe. I got my boys here from the International Committee. I got Schwinn. I'm trying to get the outside game of prior to summer games here in Barcelona, right? Tell me you don't love this game. Look at this game. Somebody give my man a monster swing. Bang! You got it? Black top shoe. I mean, you can't beat this. This is made for the outdoor game.
How do you pick the team, though?
How do you pick your team? You call game.
I got game.
No. I got game.
Yo, I got game.
No, you're never get a game. So, we definitely going to Barcelona this summer? Is that too much to ask for? Am I asking too much yet?
You can ski a live volcano. Take a dip in the Colorado. Take your bike way up in the blue. Get your tidal wave and go. You can sled without the snow. But you've never done nothing like a diet. Full Tilt taste. You won't believe it's a diet. You can leave. You can die. Take a ride in the sky.
PBS.
Well, let's check in with Sports Illustrated's Curry Kirkpatrick.
Jim, the biggest news in Lexington this week isn't the NCAA tournament, but the sale of famous Calumet Farms to a Polish businessman who paid $17 million. He outbid Billy Packer, by the way. But the interesting thing is, if he had lived, a man who had been a prime bidder, John Galbraith, the former Ohio State alumnus who helped recruit Jerry Lucas and John Havlicek to Columbus as another omen for Ohio State. The winning bidder's racing colors are red and white. Back to you guys.
After a Baker jumper, Carolina turns it over.
Good play by Ricky Dudley getting back there. The former tight end and high school football player of the year down at Texas was right on the spot on that play. You see a run coming here, Jim?
It's already started.
Yeah, you kind of feel it.
I'd say so.
That was more than a run. That was a run and a gun. And Ohio State, for the first time, shows a half-court zone trap. Both of these coaches really working well in this game. And they drop back into a zone. Think of Hubert Davis here. Grodel trying to set a screen for him.
Jackson on the baseline. A three would tie it. Salvadori fights for it. Gets it out to Phelps. Three on two. Davis on the wing.
Excellent point by Davis.
10 points for Davis.
Jim, I thought on that last possession, Ohio State should have had the ball in Jim Jackson's hands. As they did there.
Salvadori with a second rebound on two trips to
Phelps
the net.
Phelps is looking for Davis again.
Rodel.
Tough shot. Wide open.
Nobody within 10 feet of Rodel.
That's the second shot you get in around the
exactly.
world.
Exactly. A tough one to make when you're that wide open. Dudley, they're not even guarding him out front.
Chin. Lynch points to...
It's going to be Dudley coming over his back.
The offender, Ricky Dudley. And that's the seventh against Ohio State.
Here comes
one and one. One and one for George Lynch.
Wholesale substitutions coming in here. Skelton back in.
For Ohio State, Jamie Skelton.
Ohio State's five. Skelton, Funderburke, Dudley, Baker, and Gent. For Carolina, Montross, Phelps, Sullivan, Davis, and the free throw shooter, George Lynch.
Jim, you know, I think Randy Ayers over there doing a fine job tonight. The last time he faced North Carolina, he was a player. 1976, Miami of Ohio. North Carolina beat him by two, and the man that made the key basket sitting on the other bench,
Bill
not
Ford.
Dean Smith, but Bill Ford,
yeah, right.
huh?
Two-point game.
Hey, get your arms in your own way.
Back-to-back Big Ten Coach of the Year. Randy Ayers, 5-2 in the tournament, made the Sweet 16 last year as the one seed in the Midwest, and got knocked out on this night by St. John's.
Who said nice guys have to finish? They can't finish first, huh? Class individual.
He defeats that theory.
Yes, sir.
Down to three, it's back up to eight for Carolina.
How about that possession when Baker drove inside was the time to get the ball to Jackson. He's out of the game now. Who's the go to the guy?
Three-pointer. And Ohio State's now two out of ten from behind that three-point line. First points of the game for Jent.
That's his 31st three on the year. He shoots a very credible 39% from there for a power forward. That's excellent. What I think we're seeing right now is the grabbing the ball, coming through the net. Both coaches have been warned.
Bloody nose for Lynch. Maybe it's, we're now hearing it's his lip.
Pretty good passer on the inside to Montross. We've got two big men out there to feed the post.
Sullivan rarely looks to shoot. They just left him wide open out there.
He's looking to get that ball to rope inside to Montross. Tough shot.
Nearly tipped in by Phelps. Oh, it got away from Baker.
Shot they wanted there. They had enough time to hold it down to the end. They ought to hold the ball for the last shot. They didn't do it again.
Skelton comes in from behind for the steal.
That's two big mental mistakes by North Carolina.
12 turnovers in the half for the Heels. Now can the Bucks trim it to two with this three? The clock takes the shot at the buzzer. Carolina by five over Randy Ayers. seed, Ohio State. North Carolina 37, Ohio State 32. CBS Sports, exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by AT&T, proud sponsor of the 1992 U.S. Olympic team. McDonald's, what you want is what you get at McDonald's today. And by Diet Mountain Dew Full Tilt Taste, you won't believe it's a diet. Do Diet Dew.
The white zone is for immediate...
We didn't design the...
Jim and Floyd Lancia. Their homes give a new definition to affordable quality.
North Carolina has 12 turnovers. The Buckeyes of Ohio State are 14 for 38. They trail by only five. It's halftime in Lexington, and that means it's halftime here in New York City. I'm Pat O'Brien along with my partners, Mike Francesa, and the coach, Zigger Phelps. What about this game, huh, guys?
I think you hit on the highlights, Pat. Carolina's turned it over 12 times, and if I'm Ohio State in there, Zigger, the way they've shot it, Jimmy Jackson only has 4 points, 2 of 7 from the floor. I got to be pretty happy that I'm only down 5 points.
Jimmy Jackson's got to step up this half. He's not played well. He did it the other day against Connecticut. He's got to do it again today.
Jimmy Jackson's slump continues. Out to Midwest Regional semifinal out in Kemper Arena in Kansas City. Dick Stockton and Al McGuire for Georgia Tech and Memphis State. A good game. Let's take you out there now.
We got a hot game here in Kansas City, guys, in an anonymous regional. The top three seeds are out of here, as you know, and Memphis State and Georgia Tech are battling. With Memphis State leading by three, 28-25, and 5.5 minutes to go. Al McGuire, this has been an end-to-end game that we didn't really expect Georgia Tech to play.
The pace favors Memphis State. They've got to slow it down a little bit the present time. David Vaughn and Hardaway are playing outstanding offensive games. Outstanding.
UTEP and Cincinnati are in the second half of this Field of Dreams doubleheader. One of these teams will go to the Final Four. Matt Geiger is playing with two personal fouls for Georgia Tech. Leading scorer for Memphis State, Douglas with 8. John Barry has 9 to top the Yellow Jackets. Hardaway goes around Barry, and he'll go to the line. One of the better young players in the country, Anfernee Hardaway. His nickname is Penny, just a sophomore, and leads him in so many categories.
Plus, what a quick step, first one. Unbelievable. Then he tried to dunk it in that time over Mackey and picked up the foul.
What kind of a passer, and whose class do you think Hardaway can be?
He is such a good passer that he has to stop passing because he's creating too many turnovers on this club. And this club only became good about a month ago when the upperclassmen finally accepted, this is a Proposition 48, but finally accepted Hardaway and... David Vaughn,
who got the winning basket against Arkansas.
Once they accepted those two ball players, then they became a tournament team.
Hardaway has 4 assists, by the way. Memphis State shooting over 50%. He makes both free throws, and the Tigers lead by 5. They had the early lead, and then Georgia Tech went on a 12-2 run to lead by 4, but Memphis State has stormed back.
They'll trap a shooting from over half court. There was the trap. Matlock reached in. That will put John Barry on the foul line.
Soon as you turn your head.
Watch. Soon as he turns his head here, there he comes. But he reaches in, catches him with his leg. They go to the foul line for 1-1.
17 foul against Memphis State. John Barry leads Georgia Tech in scoring. 3-point shooting, assists and steals. And a 69% free throw shooter.
For Memphis State to win, they must play in Barry's face, especially in three-point land, touchdown land.
That's what USC failed to do in the second round in Milwaukee. Georgia Tech, the least expected survivor of the ACC to get to the Sweet 16, battling Memphis State and trailing by 3 with under 5 minutes remaining in the first half.
The matchup zone favoring Hardaway wherever he goes. There goes McKay out on him. Hardaway has the ball now. Come around the horn.
How would you like to recruit in that Memphis area, huh?
Oh, I think they have 9 out of their 12 ball players are from the city of Memphis.
Play together in the summers. They play together in high school before that. Hardaway Good defensive play by James Forrest. And here is Barry. Georgia Tech has some numbers. And here is Beth, the freshman from Springfield. The basket is good. And a foul.
Let's show you this if we can. Travis Best shows the ball on the right side, makes you commit, and then comes in the back door on the left side. Only God can teach this, not a coach. Watch this. Now show the ball. He shows it, brings it back, double pumps it, and puts it in the back door.
Tim Duncan committing the personal foul, and here is Travis Best. He'll never forget his 81 points in high school at Springfield, Massachusetts, and he makes sure the rest of the team doesn't forget either.
Pat O'Brien back in New York City, along with Mike Francesa and Digger Phelps. The game we've been watching here, this is a good game, 30-30.
I think really dead even, Digger and Pat, and I think the key is in the last 5 minutes, Digger, Georgia Tech with the zone has gotten the pace of the game back where they want it. They're not as deep as Memphis State. Memphis State wants to go back and forth, up and down the floor, as we talked about. And Digger, as you've been talking about to me, Georgia Tech has got to get inside in the second half against Memphis State.
They're not getting the ball to Mackey inside, and one reason, when Memphis State came out of the 12-minute mark, the press forced Tech into running down the floor, which prevents the big guys from getting the ball. And I think you can't take your press offense away to where your big guys can't get involved.
You know, Georgia Tech's a team, Pat, with a lot of momentum coming in because of what happened against USC, that little magic carpet ride. As you see Memphis State do what they do best, get up the floor and go on the break. That's what Memphis State does. That's what Georgia Tech has to guard against. They want to play at a little slower pace with the size against that Memphis State speed.
You're right about Tech, right, Coach? I mean, Bobby Kremins always gets his kids to believe they can win any game.
That's it. The zone has slowed up Memphis State.
Let's set everybody on what the night looks like here on CBS as we continue our coverage of the tournament. Michigan and Oklahoma State in the Southeast, a loaded bracket down there. That game is coming up in our around 10:30, and then some of you will see UTEP and Cincinnati. We might add that we added a viewer today, as our executive producer, Ted Shaker, had a baby boy, and so we congratulate him and Cheryl, and
absolutely.
He is beaming, and Molly and Gracie, get ready for G.I. Joe in your house. The road to the Final Four continues here on CBS. Stay with us.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship Regional Semifinal Game is sponsored by Oldsmobile, official car for NCAA Championships. Goodyear, number one in tires. And by Budweiser, the king of beers, for that clean, crisp, cold taste. Nothing beats a Bud.
As we're getting set for the second half from Rupp Arena, North Carolina over Ohio State by five. Davis and Montross with 10 points apiece. And let's check in with our Curry Kirkpatrick.
Jim, here in horse country, the simple fact is that Ohio State has a horse and nobody's riding him. They've got to get the ball to Jim Jackson. Randy Ayers told the Buckeyes, we're not rebounding the ball, we're not transitioning the ball, and we got to get it in the hands of Jimmy. Do it. Dean Smith is happy with everything his guys did, except the last minute when their shot selection was so poor. He felt he should be up by 9 points. Back to you guys.
All right. Jackson's 2 for 7. Both of his baskets on dunks, Billy.
Well, here we're going to see what Ohio State did well in the first half, and that is when they drove the ball to the baseline, North Carolina very uncharacteristically got themselves in a position out of position. Now, let's take a look right here. Eric Montross going to protect the baseline. Normally, you'd get a double team down there, but what happens? North Carolina pulls out on Gent. We're going to see the drive by Baker. When Montross goes, nobody helps out from the weak side, and a bounce pass goes inside for one of Funderburke's 10 points. North Carolina failing on defense. Ohio State doing a great job on the baseline with their passing.
Carolina to inbounds to start the second half. The winner will be one step from the Final Four. North Carolina got there last year. Ohio State's last Final Four, 1968. But it lost to North Carolina in the national semifinals. And then beat Houston for the third place game. And Montross with the left hand. 12 points now for Montross, top man of the game.
And Jim, every time that Ohio State has been down at halftime this year, which has been 5 times, they have lost the ball game. North Carolina surprisingly has been down at halftime in 16 games this year. Found themselves with 9 wins and 7 losses. That's very unusual for a top-notch team.
Ball missing the three. Jackson.
Great pump fake by Jim Jackson.
Had two defenders right on him. Was able to maneuver the body around him. court on George Lynch with the ball, a cut lip, no stitches. He's back in and throws it away. Jackson starts the second half with two quick baskets. After two out of seven in the first half.
Boy, North Carolina really depends on Phelps to handle the ball out in the midcourt area all the time. That time, Reese was wide open. Good block there, Rupp.
Tied it up. Arrow belongs to the Buckeyes.
And here's where Dean Smith has to be thinking about the way his team responded in the last 40 seconds of the first half, when they could have had a little bit of a working margin. Now Ohio State has a position with a three-point shot to tie this thing. And there it is.
7 points right out of the locker room for Jimmy Jackson. And the game's tied.
Caught Phelps in the air. Tried to help out from the weak side. Tough young man right there is Gent.
First on Gent. Game tied 39-all.
That was in the act of shooting, but it wasn't. He was looking to make the pass. Looks like Ohio State stepped things up defensively. Time to go down inside on Montross again.
Montross has not missed in this game. 5 for 5 from the floor. He hit both of his free throws.
Remember, 11 for 13 against Miami, Ohio.
Davis, right at the bottom of the net.
Just a two, Jim.
12 for Davis.
Keeps it alive.
Gent makes the basket to tie it at 41.
That was Lynch's problem. He was the man back and didn't block out Jim Jackson. You've got to keep him off the boards. He's sensational going to the offensive boards.
Phelps with a quick basket at the other end.
On the offensive board.
Oh, they reversed their call. First they sent North Carolina, then they reversed it.
Now, that was just good officiating there, because the official realized that he had called it the other way, quickly reversed his call. There's Jackson again. Tough to keep off the boards. Lynch is as good a blockout man as you'd want. Got a lot of strength. Tough to keep Jackson
out of there. Ohio State takes the lead at 44-43. Chris Gent with a three.
Brown on that catch.
Away from the ball, a foul against North Carolina. And Lynch, his first. Second on the Tar Heels in the half. State is on a 12-4 run, fueled by Jim Jackson's 7 points. And a moment ago, Chris Gent with a three from the corner to give the Buckeyes the one-point lead. 16:38 left in this.
Now, Jim, you know, we've seen Ohio State this year in the regular season at Indiana, of course, and against Connecticut in the NCAA tournament, put on great runs, as good as anybody has all year in college basketball. And this is another classic one.
Wild shot by Gent. This is Ohio State's first lead since 11-10. Davis tries to get it right back, but a break opportunity now for the Buckeyes. Jamal Brown.
And there's Funderburke, his quickness.
Montross commits the foul. His second. Game's
summary, field goal percentages, Carolina near 60%, Ohio State 38.
Jim, that has changed a little bit the second half. We said at the top of the show that what both of these teams were holding their opponents down to 35%. North Carolina continued that mastery in the first half. Ohio State has picked it up here now. We also talked about the fact that both teams' superstars, offensively Davis and Jackson, had not had big games so far as percentage shooting. But both are playing well now, particularly Jackson in the second half.
Ohio State, Carolina winner will play the winner of Michigan and Oklahoma State, the second game tonight in the Southeast. Brian Reese has come back in for North Carolina, replacing Henrik Rodel.
I'm anxious to see how long Randy Ayers will go with this starting lineup as his, because the pace of this game is really up-tempo. Funderburke had to come out early in the first half. I would expect the move have to come here in the next couple of minutes for him. Very tough contest to play a lot of consecutive minutes inside.
The shot clock. Reese gives it up at the last minute.
That was Funderburke again. His quickness was able to prevent Reese from making the layup and then getting back to deflect the pass.
An official's timeout. Ohio State has taken the lead.
It's just another Saturday afternoon. All those old guys came out of the woods. With axes. Just when they thought it couldn't get any weirder, it did. They even brought their own music.
Awesome! Hey, fellas, how about a cold bud?
A bud?
Obviously, we thought alike.
Oh, that's cold.
Lunch time!
Yeah! We're out of pizzerias. Let's make our own.
Make pizzerias?
Uncle Ernie does it. How hard can it be?
You take real pizza dough,
add cheese, real pizza spices.
Exotic, man.
Then make it all into crunchy chips. Oh, that's the tricky part.
Allow me, boys.
Pizzerias! Tastes like real pizza. Oh, louder. How'd you do that, Uncle Ernie?
Grown-up magic.
And going...
freedom. It's the spirit which moves the Cutlass Supreme, a car intelligently engineered to free your eyes, your hands, your senses. Introducing the new Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme. The look may change, but the spirit remains the same. Oldsmobile, the power of intelligent engineering.
The Oldsmobile drive to the Final Four Cellathon. It's your best shot for a great deal now.
Have you ever dreamed you could fly? Now, the world's greatest illusionist conquers the mystery of human flight without wings, strings, or camera tricks. An all-new Magic of David Copperfield, Tuesday.
Jim Nance along with Billy Packer from the Southeast Regional. Ohio State was down 5 at halftime. Come back to take the lead and has possession.
Oh, great pass by Jim.
Traveled outside.
North Carolina was looking for the pass to go from the foul line forward. Instead, Jen just weaved it right through there. North Carolina only had one man back. Hard-nosed man-to-man. That was an important timeout for Ohio State. Funderburke was really getting tired. They picked up the TV timeout. Really helped them.
Lynch on the blocks.
For him from the perimeter.
11 overall. This is Ohio State's largest lead, a 5-point advantage.
Oh, good cut by Lynch. He can't get anything to fall.
Montross fouled on the way up by Gent.
Now, North Carolina had a great rub-off cut that time for Lynch. Got exactly the shot he wanted the last two occasions. Neither one of them would drop.
Funderburke's first.
He has had an outstanding game, Jim, not only statistically, but he's been everywhere. his quickness down on the inside. It's amazing.
Two for Montross. That's his first miss of the night. Again, he had made all five of his shots from the floor. It had been two out of two from the line. Montross, a teammate for the U.S. Pan Am team with Jim Jackson. Randy Ayers was an assistant coach for Gene Cady.
Here comes the jump double team now by North Carolina. And Jen, as hot as he is, you can't let him alone.
Not this one.
A case where Montross was better off blocking out his man rather than trying to retrieve the ball. It would have been North Carolina's ball out of bounds. He took himself out of position.
He's got position on this end.
This is the second one for Funderburke in a hurry.
This was an air ball that would have been...
Now see, if Montross just blocks his man out and doesn't try to retrieve it, the ball comes right back to him. He needed to put a body on him, and that left him wide open underneath the basket of Funderburke for an easy two.
Funderburke able to add to his array of dunks on the night. I believe that's five now for him.
Well, you talk about what might have been. Funderburke, of course, could have been playing for Bob Knight out in the West region. Here he is. And Jim, we've talked about this between ourselves. How about if Montross had decided to follow his father to Michigan?
Then there may not have been a Fab Five.
Right. Then Juwan Howard says, well, I don't want to play behind that center. He doesn't go to Michigan. So Weber and Rose take off to Michigan State and Syracuse. We'd have an entirely different NCAA tournament.
Montross hits two of the ugliest free throws you'll ever see. And the lead is at four with 14 minutes remaining.
North Carolina now, instead of that trap, goes back to the zone. Jackson wanting a jumper.
Wants the three. I think Davis may have gotten a hand on that. It was an odd rotation. And Rodel stops, skip pass. Davis, three.
Three-point basket.
Right, Rodel does such a good job on the skip pass. He's got the size at about 6'8", the C-cross court, and he delivers that ball extremely well. He was the solidifying factor in the first half for North Carolina when he came in off the bench.
That was Carolina's first three of the night. 6-point lead is down to one.
That's Davis's first three in the NCAA tournament. He was 0-for-9 coming into this game. Jackson's getting buried on his own down and low.
Kick by Phelps. Ohio State will inbound.
And a new 45. If you slap it out of bounds with your hands to deflect the ball, it's a good defensive play and the clock stays as is. But if you kick it out of bounds, it goes back to the 45. Stays in the zone. They got to be aware of Jent, who's now buried inside.
That was tipped by Phelps, who is outstanding at getting steals. In fact, set a North Carolina record this year with 9 in one game. Broke Dudley Bradley's record of 8.
They had tied it earlier in the year with 8, and then broke it against Georgia Tech with 9. Jim, you're right on it.
Alley.
Came in behind the zone. Nobody realized that he was there. Perfectly thrown pass.
17 for Funderburke. Davis. This is the lay-in. Montross boxing out.
By Montross.
Pretty good play by Montross there to go up for the second jump. Might be Funderburke getting a little tired against that body.
Montross matches Funderburke 17.
Did Jackson hustle after that loose ball?
Jackson now with 13.
Now Jackson stepped out that time. Rodel been banging him inside. That was off. That was a carry that time by Phelps. He put it on his hip and got by with it.
Davis working inside. Oh, what a foul by Montross.
And the young man from Indianapolis is starting to become a real load in there.
He has 19. He set his career high again, 22 against Miami. He could beat it tonight.
And he just gave Dean Smith the signal that he's ready to sit down for a while. And you can see both coaches realizing the big men are expending so much energy, they've got to sit down.
Baker. Phelps with the rebound. Carolina can take the lead, a 3-on-2. Rodel back out to Phelps.
When you're tired, you don't shoot that jumper too well.
Ohio State basketball. Television timeout with 11 minutes to go. 1-point game in game one at Lexington.
A dream team Saturday.
I'm with Dick Schultz, the executive director of the NCAA. Dick, you were coach at Iowa of the Big Ten, athletic director of Virginia of the ACC. Who are you rooting for tonight?
Well, I've got to be partial. You know how it is. I can pull for both sides and still be a winner.
Dick, you've got a lot of marquee teams left in this tournament. It's got to be a good sign for you.
It really is. I think it's going to be a great tournament, a great Final Four.
Thank you. Back to you guys.
Salvadori in at center for Carolina. Robinson in for Ohio State.
Jim, I like the way Randy Ayers is substituting. He brought in fresh guards, and he wants to be able to try to retain this lead. Give Baker and Brown an opportunity to get a good, solid rest here. He used the timeout to pick up valuable minutes, as Dean Smith did with Montross. But I think Randy is trying to get his team in a position to go down that last 5 minutes with fresh guards in the game. And that could really hurt North Carolina, because Phelps has been out there a long time, played 40 minutes in the last game. And tonight he has been out there most of the minutes. They can't play without him down the stretch.
Gets it out of the double team. DeReese and the Tar Heels take the lead back. The fresh guards are Davis and Skelton for Ohio State. They turned it over the last trip.
Skelton wide open. Nobody's guarding him. Reese didn't realize what his matchup was. He thought he was in a man for man. He was guarding Jackson, and they're back to the point zone. He recognized now.
Jackson.
That is locked. Well, this is the first time Salvadori and Montross have been in there, so Jim Jackson has to realize they've got 2 7-footers. A little bit more careful when he goes inside.
State foul.
And this is a pretty good move by Dean Smith. We talk about these coaches working with each other. He goes to his 2 7-footers. And Randy Ayers goes to his 2 small guards. Now, both of those guys pretty good perimeter shooters, and they've got to look to keep the ball out of the perimeter and stick a jumper.
Funderburke stays on the bench.
And he's trying to keep his team rested for that final 5 minutes.
After the foul on Davis, Phelps at the line for Carolina.
Jim, I would make a prediction that if North Carolina doesn't get themselves up about 6 points before Funderburke, Brown, and Baker get back in there, it really is a gamble that will pay off for Randy Ayers.
3-point lead.
And it takes a lot of guts for a young coach to sit over there against one of the truly great coaches of all time and try to battle wits with him here with this substitution. Shots to key.
Davis misses a 3. Oh, Carolina let a rebound get away. Under 10 minutes to go.
Now Davis is shooting better from 3 than he is from 2, but he's got to hit one of those jump shots.
Pump fake gives it up to Jett. Assist by Davis.
Skelton's job now is just to wear Phelps down.
Salvadori inside. Robinson hacks him.
Good feed by Reese. Right over the top.
Now they're coming back in. They're checking in. Funderburke and Dudley. Billy, 14 years ago tonight, Kentucky beat Duke in the national championship game, 94-88. That man, Jack Gibbons, his jersey hangs here in Rupp Arena. He had 41 in that championship game.
He shot those little 12 to 15 foot jump shots, and they never even touched the rim that day.
And they'll have a rematch of sorts tomorrow in the East Final, you'll see on CBS. Salvadori at the line.
What's interesting, the man who took a team to the Final Four that year and set up that Final Four matchup was Eddie Sutton. He took that great Arkansas club there, but they were knocked off.
Arkansas and Notre Dame, the other two teams of that Final right. Four.
Our man Digger Phelps in the studio there. Coach the other team, obviously.
George Lynch comes in for Dean Smith, replacing Salvadori.
So Dean Smith said, I'm going to rest my big people. Randy Ayer said, I need to rest my guards for the stretch run. I have not seen a team, I don't think ever, beat North Carolina in the baseline as much as North Carolina, as much as Ohio State has tonight. Normally they double team you down there.
Reese got in trouble. To Davis, baseliner.
There's just good patience by Davis.
Davis, the only senior for North Carolina. They do have a couple of walk-ons, but the only senior scholarship player. Funderburke, turn around.
Having a great night. And he comes back in now rested.
Billy, we're looking at the future of the big men in college basketball. A pair of sophomores dueling tonight. Funderburke and Montross.
That's that little half hook, but nobody else on the weak side to help rebound.
Ohio State now with a chance to go back in front. Skelton with the three.
Well, it has paid off for Randy Ayers. He's been able to rest his guards and actually put himself in the lead. Now it's Dudley on Montross down there, just trying to lean on him, use his power. Oh, nice reverse move by Davis.
Boy, he has the feeling now.
But see, he's expending a lot of energy right now, Jim, and he's being guarded by Skelton. In a minute or two, he's going to be guarded by Brown and Baker. And they'll have fresh legs.
Funderburke misses the lay-in. Dudley may have traveled.
I think they're going to call a foul. I thought Funderburke was fouled as well.
Foul against Montross.
He can't believe it.
Montross is third. And the third against North Carolina in this half. That's all. Television timeout with the game deadlocked at 63.
Timeout on the floor.
You are watching the NCAA Basketball Championship on CBS.
Jim Nance along with Billy Packer, Curry Kirkpatrick from Lexington, game tied with 7:15 remaining. Jackson over Rodel.
That was called an NBA, I'm clearing you out.
He's always been a second half player, hasn't he?
Oh, yeah. Well, you remember last year, scored over 60% of his points in the second half. Obviously, doing it here tonight, only had two. I only had 4 points at halftime. Boy, Ricky Dudley's really banging Montross around inside, which is exactly what his job is supposed to be.
Lynch one-handed. Jackson way up for the rebound. His seventh.
They want to set up that double low for Jackson again to work on Rodel.
Jackson driving, spinning lane.
He is some player.
Four-point Buckeye lead.
Two-time Big Ten Player of the Year has taken over. Very dangerous pass.
Tough pass between two defenders. And Jackson came out of the pile with it. Got it to Baker. 15 North Carolina turnovers.
And what Randy Ayers is doing is saying, I want the ball in the hands of Jim Jackson the rest of the way. It's a very good move on his part. Let's see how they get it to him. Here he comes. So patient. Here he comes again.
Rodel got a hand on it to deflect it. Dudley saves. 15 on the shot clock.
Pretty good hands by Dudley. Randy Ayers thinks that Jim Jackson can take Rodel.
Baker. And Funderburke brings it out. A new 45 for Ohio State.
timeout by Ohio State, making sure they get a good basket or an opportunity here to get a good basket.
Buckeyes call it with 5:13 remaining.
Things are different.
Ohio State will inbound near midcourt. Field goal percentage for the Buckeyes up to 42%. And Ohio State, 9 fewer turnovers. Montross and Funderburke are big numbers. Buckeyes by 4 with possession.
North Carolina goes back to the zone. They've had a hard time matching up with Jackson, so they go back to play zone.
Ricky Dudley still in the game for the Buckeyes down inside.
And doing a real job on Montross, Jim. He's been strong enough to body him. So Funderburke is free from. Shelton, a dangerous shooter.
Baker. And Lynch comes down with it for Carolina. His fifth rebound.
Thought Ohio State would have been better to have Baker up at the point that time, have Skelton on the wing to let him shoot that jumper.
Turn around for Montross.
Pushed by Lynch, got away with it.
Well, we gotta add him, baby.
North Carolina has not been able to get anybody free. Skelton on a reach.
Sixth team foul against Ohio State. I look on the court and see those uniforms, and it looks like the blue-gray game should be taking place in Montgomery, Alabama.
Well, how about those sneakers, Ohio State sneakers? That's a new fashion statement.
They're 6-0 with the gray sneakers.
Right. And Ohio and North Carolina has a fashion statement of their own with those warm-ups of theirs. Oh, Lynch missed Montross.
Tar Heels
door cut.
Gone 3.5 minutes, Billy, without scoring.
They're trying to get Davis open for a jumper, but Skelton's fresh legs are staying right with him.
Tough pass, Montross banks it home.
By Montross.
He's got some strong hands, Jim. He took that right away from Ricky Dudley, who, as we know, has very strong hands.
Montross with 21, one off his career high. 2-point lead for the Buckeyes, the 1 seed. Carolina, the 4 seed.
Well, I really think they need to get Brown up the top here now. Let Skelton get on the wing. The jump shot's going to come from the wing. There he is,
Skelton.
Funderburke, what a game! Skelton was in the right place. You knew the jumper would come from out the wing. He's been hitting
them. Dean Smith was calling. Looked like for a timeout.
Yeah, he said that the ball hit the top of the backboard and touched a stanchion up there. I don't think he's right on that. Funderburke doing a great job. Again, Jim, not necessarily on the first leap for the rebound, but on the second one, he's so quick off the floor. And now Jett comes back in, totally rested. A great job by Dudley, and Randy Ayers giving him a hand. He gave him exactly what he wanted.
Jackson hit with his third, and Reese goes to the line. Funderburke's basket gives him a career-high 21 points. Jimmy Jackson with 3. 3 personals. Salvadori returns for North Carolina. 1 more for Reese.
Reese, of course, hit that winning basket to beat Wake Forest this year when North Carolina was 22 down in the second half. Strokes in 2 good free throws there for the Tar Heels.
That was their biggest comeback in school history. Right. They're a team of comebacks this year. They'll need one more tonight.
Can you imagine the first time a North Carolina player ever hit a winning shot at the buzzer in the Dean Dome? Yeah, good block by Salvadori. Needs to slow down. No place to go here. Well, Funderburke again with a rebound.
7 rebounds for him.
What Reese does on the drive, Jim, he makes his decision up much too early, and therefore the defense can get organized to meet him on the inside.
3-pointer, big one. Jamie Skelton.
Jim, there he was, out on the wing with the opportunity to shoot the jumper against this zone.
What a feisty off-the-bench player he is.
Short.
That was a force by Davis. Lynch, he banks it home. It's down to three. Ohio State by three.
Looks like they want to spread it out a little bit and force North Carolina to come and chase them outside the zone. Big advantage here has to be for Brown with Phelps guarding him. Phelps got to be a little tired. Tough to chase here. And you know who they're going to want to have the ball in their hands as it winds down the 10-second mark. Jim Jackson. Key to get the ball to him.
Skelton has hit a three and just scored a moment ago on a driving layup to give Ohio State a five-point lead. Darren Phelps right back quickly. And out of bounds belonging to Ohio State.
That was Gent using a good block out, and here's Phelps, a weary young man.
Montross and Rodel will come in for Reese and Salvadori.
Now, what Dean Smith is going to try to do now is to substitute for defense. I'm surprised he's not taking Phelps out there. He wanted.
Look out. Lynch steals it just like he did against Miami. Davis misses the three. Lynch runs it down. Phelps can cut it to two.
Look at Davis rebound.
Rodel. Timeout, North Carolina.
Wanted a charge.
47 seconds to go. And the Buckeyes lead it by three. On the game reset, team fouls.
Well, Jim, every coach in America likes to be in a situation where you play solid defense and don't commit fouls. And here's the time when North Carolina finds themselves behind the eight ball, because Ohio State does not have to go to the line, so North Carolina's going to have to commit four more fouls here, and every time they commit one, the clock is going to run. I'm surprised Dean Smith hasn't put in some substitutes just to commit quick fouls and try to stop the clock immediately.
Chris Gent called the timeout for Ohio State. The Buckeyes are left with one. They lead it by three. Ohio State has come back from a five-point halftime deficit.
Jim, right now, North Carolina has to foul immediately here. Now, they should go after a big steal. Just go after the steal right away. You can't intentionally foul. There was about two-tenths of a second off. There's holding on Rodel. And I am surprised that Dean Smith has not put in some guys to make these intentional fouls. You want to go for the steal. Now they've got to commit three more before they can force Ohio State to go to the line. You see Sullivan all the way back for defense.
Going
for the steal. He doesn't get it. There's the foul. That's the second one.
Sullivan tried to jump in there and...
I'll tell you what, if I'm Ohio State, I take one chance to go long here.
The
screen and go long and maybe get an easy basket, because North Carolina is playing to steal the inbounds pass.
That's now five team fouls against the Tar Heels.
They got to come in another foul. There's the reach. Well done by Lynch. He did not grab the shirt. He did not pick up the intentional foul.
So it's taken them 7 seconds to commit three fouls.
Now this next one puts them on the line. Now you want to be a little bit more aware of who's in the game to see if you can foul the man that you want.
They send Jamal Brown to the line. He's a 74% free throw shooter.
And that may look easy to say, let's get the ball in bounds, but when the other team doesn't have to worry about fouling you, that is a tough assignment, and Ohio State carried it out very well.
Montross back in.
Jim, and if you're North Carolina, you've got to be thinking threes now, so it's Hubert Davis time.
Carolina had committed three fouls in 19 minutes.
Now four in the last 8 seconds.
And you see who's back in the game, Jamal Brown. So you know who. He's totally rested. He's been on that bench for 8 minutes or so. You know he'll be matched up against Hubert Davis.
One of three senior starters and a captain for the Buckeyes.
Oh, they'll have one more.
Well, you look down that lineup of starters. All are excellent free throw shooters with the exception of Funderburke, and he's at 64-8. But he probably is not going to touch the ball in the open court.
He gets one of two, not even close on the second one. 4-point lead for Ohio State. That's a big rebound. Chip boxed out Reese, and he'll go to the line.
Well,
Carolina had more rebounders in the area, but when it came Gent's way, he had boxed out his man, Brian Reese.
Jim, again, I'm going to go back to that excellent substituting by Randy Ayers, and not to say that Dean Smith didn't do well with his team, but Ayers really played some calculated gambles by resting Gent, Brown, and Baker, and Funderburke, and now they come back in with fresh legs, and they get to the ball a little quick.
1-1, he hits the front end.
And you shoot free throws better when you're rested as well. There you see Dudley and Skelton, two very key players in this game for Ohio State. A gutsy move by Randy Ayers. Last year, you'd say as a coach, he might have not had a real good game against Louis Carnesecca. Remember when he got knocked out on the press?
The 16 game last year.
Right, tonight he has been all over.
6-point lead, Reese flying. No Carolina rebounder in sight.
And they got a foul again. They can't get to Baker.
We'll be sending you to Georgia Tech and Memphis State when this game ends.
Jim, you talked about the Final Four where North Carolina beat Ohio State. Go back to another Final Four in 46 when these two teams met in the semifinals. North Carolina won that one, and then they lost in the final to a team we'll see coming up next, Oklahoma State.
Amazing to think that three of the four Final Four teams in 46 are right here at this regional.
That's right.
1-1 for Baker, 18 seconds to go.
Gotta go three.
Gotta get it to Rodel or Rodel. And his back turn.
Well, and you can see that Davis is blanketed by Brown. Davis is the man you'd want to get it to. There was still plenty of time for North Carolina. They could have buried a three there, down six. They just needed one more possession.
Jamal Brown, and this will be a two-shot situation because it's 10 team fouls.
But that's the only strategy that Dean Smith could use. You've got to stop the clock. Funderburke and Jackson out there at half court. Two fellas had a sensational game. Jim Jackson with the second half comeback that he always puts on for people. Funderburke carried him with those dunks all the way through this game.
7-point lead. That'll do it. Comes in for Carolina, in for Lynch. 8-point margin is the largest of the game for Ohio State.
Now they're looking to go long to Davis, and Brown recognizes the eye contact between Renstrom and Davis. He's not going to let him touch it. If not, I don't know about that strategy. Get it by the left hand.
Timeout called by Carolina with 8 seconds to go. Down six. Randy Ayers trying to make it to the regional final. Buckeye fans everywhere at Rupp Arena.
Take a
advantage of this timeout to get you up to date on Georgia Tech, Memphis State. John Berry was just hit in the face under the basket, and there you see his mother looking on with some concern. He's had a great game. The score now, Georgia Tech leads by 3, 67-64. Memphis State in the white jerseys, Mike. Good game, huh?
And John Berry, 28 points, has had a phenomenal game, Pat, for Georgia Tech. He looked like he was hit by his own man there, Malcolm Mackey, underneath the basket. And Memphis State had trouble in this game, fell behind 10 points, but they continue to stay in. And Anthony Hardaway, the big player, 19 points for Memphis State. He's the guy to watch down the stretch of this ballgame.
We just want to remind everybody that we're going to take you all to the finish of this game, and Digger, it looks like a great finish.
Well, I'll tell you, James Forrest has stepped up the second half, the freshman for Georgia Tech. He's got 12 points, 11 rebounds for the game, and with Berry out, he may even have to step up higher.
Three-point game, 4:23. Left in the ball game, and of course we'll send you all out there as soon as the game is done in Lexington. There's 8 seconds left there. Ohio State with a 6-point lead. Let's go back to Jim and Billy.
And you remember where Ohio State clinched the Big Ten championship? A place called Minneapolis. Beat Minnesota.
Destroyed Minnesota last weekend. Gent will inbound.
The object here is just to get the ball in play. Almost running out of bounds play as if it's going to North Carolina's basket, because you're sure to get the ball there. I'm surprised Ohio State may not step a guy off on the end line. You're not set up to do that, but it's a very good way to ensure yourself the opportunity to get the ball back in bounds. A lot of spacing here to make a long pass. Somebody's got to cut back towards Jen. I would say Baker or Jackson cutting off a Funderburke. There goes Baker. Here comes Jackson.
Six seconds to go and Carolina about to get knocked out by almost an identical score. It could be an identical score to last year's loss to Kansas. Kansas beat them in the semifinals, 79-73. That's the score right now for Ohio State.
And, of course, remember, on this very court, North Carolina got knocked out by the eventual national champion, Michigan.
In 89.
That's right. Who we will be seeing in a few minutes.
Dean Smith will be now 0-2 at Rupp Arena. Jackson for two. Four in the first half, 13 in the second, as you see. Seven rebounds.
There we see Phil Ford, Bill Guthridge, Dean Smith. How about Bill Guthridge over there? He's been on that bench with Dean for a long time.
25 years, the man to the upper left of your screen. Longest term at one school for an assistant in college basketball.
Oh, he should have leaned right into Jett and got the foul.
Ohio State is one step from the Final Four. The Buckeyes become the third number one seed to make it to a regional final, joining Duke in the East, UCLA in the West. And the Buckeyes will play the winner of Michigan and Oklahoma State, 30 minutes away. By the way, Ohio State was 2-0 this year against the Wolverines.
And Jim, remember when we talked to the Wolverines, they said even at that time when Ohio State looked like they couldn't possibly win the Big Ten, both Chris Webber and Jalen Rose said Ohio State is the better team between Indiana and Ohio State. And there we see two fellas that played an excellent game. Montross, our Chevy player of the game for North Carolina, wasn't he, Jim?
He is indeed. Montross, 21 points, 12 rebounds. And Funderburke for Ohio State. The Chevrolet Players of the Game, $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school. As we saw, Hubert Davis, a magnificent senior season. His career at Carolina is over. Ohio State advances. The Jackson 5 is into the regional final. been a presentation of CBS Sports. Let's send you back to Pat O'Brien.
All right, Jim, we'll see you a little bit later. And so across North Carolina, off your brackets is...